Hello everyone. As you have been reading in the text, a number of decisions need to be made and a number of parameters must be optimised before we can even begin to perform the diagnostic ultrasound scan. Let's look at some practical examples of this. Now the first choice we must make is the type of transducer that we're going to use. Here you can see that there are two linear transducers labelled with their transmitting frequency on the front face. The one in the front is 9 MHz and the one at the back can transmit at multiple frequencies ranging from 6 MHz to 15 MHz. Now recall that the higher the frequency, the better the resolution but at the loss of penetration. So these high frequencies therefore can give you a clue as to the use of these transducers. They are used to visualise superficial structures such as the thyroid, the breast, and many tendons such as those in the shoulder, the wrist and the ankle. Now this transducer is a curved transducer and it transmits frequencies between 1 and 5 MHz. Such low frequencies mean that we can penetrate deep into the body, so this transducer is used for imaging of the abdomen and the pelvis. Now the curved nature of this footprint enables excellent transducer skin contact so we don't get any air in between. Some transducers are manufactured for a very special purpose, such as this endocavity transducer with a long handle. It is placed inside the patient to give very high resolution images of structures such as early pregnancy sacs, the lining of the uterus, and the prostate gland. So once we've selected the transducer, we must then decide what depth of tissue we wish to display. Now we want to display the part of anatomy that we will be looking at to fill the entire screen. So you can see here that we start by looking at the liver. There's a large field of view, there is a bright band at the back which is the diaphragm, and the right kidney can be seen sitting next to the liver. Now as I reduce the depth, I effectively zoom in my image until only the anterior aspect of the liver can be seen. By doing this, we tailor the depth to be displayed to include just the area that we're interested in. So once we have the right transducer and we have the right depth, we must then optimise the image to have a uniform brightness throughout. It makes sense that the echoes returning from the deeper tissues will have less energy associated with them than those from the closer tissues. Now we need to be able to preferentially amplify them on an individual basis. This is done using this slider. Each slide corresponds to a band of tissue at a certain depth. Now you can see here how this works in a real-time image of the liver. As I move each slider, you can see the image becoming lighter or darker at discrete tissue depths.